First of all, my name is Pather. That's the most important thing you need to know today. Second thing you need to know is if you have a mobile phone on, please put it to silent if you can. It's probably me phoning you just to test. So I prefer if you kept them quiet. The other thing, oh yes, well done, that's brilliant. Then we have a winner, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time.
Yeah.
Yes. The next thing is, we've all heard this already before, you all know the truth. This is a non-spoiler panel. Many people here have read the books. Not everybody has read all the books, including the gentleman to my left. Please, I beg of you, on my knees, do not discuss the incredibly disturbing thing that happens in book two. Okay? Just don't do it. Or the even more disturbing things in book three. We're strictly sticking, book five and food-related things we're not discussing. We are sticking strictly to the series, okay? So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask each of the panel if they would like to introduce themselves. I could introduce them. I, like the rest of you here, admire them greatly, including the artist, William Simpson, who delighted my youth with Rogue Trooper and things like that, and Judge Dredd. But I am going to ask them just to briefly introduce themselves, and after that we'll take a few questions, which will probably fill up the hour very, very handily. Okay.
Hello, well, I'm Christian and I play Hodor.
Hodor!
Hi, I'm William Simpson and I draw lots of pictures.
I'm Sophie Turner and I play Sansa Stark.
I'm Maisie Williams and I play Arya Stark.
I'm Art Parkinson and I play Rickon Stark.
Hello, I'm Miltus Yoruba and I play
just so. Okay. Can we take our first question from the floor? Anybody like to volunteer a question, or would you like me to ask some questions? It's up to you. Do we have a volunteer for a question? Anybody want to ask anything? Nobody? Okay. Well, I'll go ahead. Let's see who we start with. We could ask Christian, well, he was already asked earlier on, about how difficult it was to learn his lines. But there was a famous scene you were in, Christian, a very famous scene. My girlfriend wanted me to ask you, was any CGI used?
I've never actually answered this officially. I've always sort of diverted answers, but there's no CGI. There was more rubber used in the Michelin tire factory. I'm actually thankful for it because I wouldn't be able to stand up because I would have no blood in my head if that was real.
I think a few people fainting in the audience there, but otherwise we're quite happy. I'm going to go move on next to William. You start off in comic books, as far as I know, and please correct me if I'm wrong. And now you do storyboards for movies, including Reign of Fire and City of Ember, and now Game of Thrones. I'm sure most people here know what a storyboard is, but could you roughly describe, you know, from an artist's point of view, what it is and what kind of insight that gives you that ordinary mortals don't get into the series?
Well, the great thing is, it's just like doing a comic strip, so I haven't really changed my profession. I've just moved from comics into storyboarding and conceptual artwork. The great thing with storyboarding is that you're working through the director's ideas and also bearing in mind different camera angles and all of the things that are going to make the show look good, you know, apart from all those actors. it's a constantly changing thing as well. I mean, you have to be there so that the director comes in when he's had his third version of an idea, and you then alter storyboards accordingly. And basically, it's they always used to tell me it was for the action stuff, but it's not necessarily so. It's more for different tracking shots and so on, where we see where actors are going to be placed. And if a director goes on to the set with all of this knowledge in his hands, it makes life easier. He only has to deal with the actors rather than having to think about all of the rest of the setups, because they've already been decided. Okay?
That's great. We have a question from Joe Campo.
Hi. Just a follow-up to that. Do you work with a cinematographer in creating a setup or a shot? I mean, obviously, conceptually, it originally comes from you, or...?
It's been very odd in Game of Thrones, because some of the earlier stuff, I was working with a line producer on it, and we were we were coming up with versions of what the scenes would be like on the basis of, hey, let's get this story started and try and make sure that we have some structure to it. And when the cinematographers come to town, then I do occasionally work with them, but it's mostly with the directors. Sometimes the director and the cinematographer are very closely knit, so the mixture of ideas that I'm getting fed are from both of them, but a lot of the time it's just me and the director, and the sessions seem to go on for hours with the pair of us just sitting laughing over things, It's always good, because it's like thinking about all the terrible things that are going to happen to these people is pretty, pretty fantastic. I mean, I was so disappointed that Sansa didn't kick Joffrey off the edge. Oh,
well, that brings us to a very obvious question. Only the real Sansa really knows why. But for Sophie. Can we ask you, obviously a lot of people dislike Sansa the character. A lot of people. Has it ruined your life?
We love Sansa!
Bruce! Sansa! A lot of people do dislike Sansa, and I suppose they disliked her in the book, so I'm kind of doing my job. Hopefully well. But sometimes, the dislike goes a bit too far and people say horrible things about Sansa that they want to happen to her.
Have you been pelted with tomatoes in the street?
No, luckily. sometimes it goes too far and it upsets me, because then, I kind of feel like I'm making her too annoying. Am I making her, people want to kill her, really? It hurts, but,
don't feel sorry for me.
I suppose I am doing my job. People dislike her. I don't, but that's my opinion.
If we can move on to the popular one. Oh, that cuts deeper than swords. I was lucky enough to sit in on the earlier press conference, and Maisie, I think you were saying stuff about how difficult it is coping with school and filming at the same time. Could you tell the audience a little bit about that?
It's two completely different lives, and I didn't have a clue what to expect when I came along. And it is very different, and to go back into school where they treat you as children, and obviously I am, but it's a really different world, because when you're over here, the only thing that separates the children from the adults is the working hours, that's it. Anything else is all exactly the same, and it's nice that they treat you like an adult, but it's two completely different worlds, and to try and mix the two, it doesn't really work. So if I go back to school now, this probably wouldn't come up in the conversations, just because it's not the sort of thing that happens, and it's hard fitting back in, so we tend to sort of stay over here in large chunks and then go back for big chunks, just because going forward and backwards is quite tricky. But I wouldn't change it for the world, but sometimes it does get a bit much, and you sort of wonder what it'd be like if you weren't doing it at all. But no, I wouldn't change it. It is great.